Hi, welcome to Audit Talk. My name is Eric Groen, and I'm a managing director with Protiviti. I'm really excited today to have Ed Ho with us. Ed is the internal audit director for Green Dot Corporation.
Yes.
Tell us more about Green Dot Corporation, yourself, as well as your internal audit team.
We are a fintech company. We start off, you know, focusing on prepaid cards. So we sell prepaid card, gift card, in the past few years, you know, we changed our focus to financial services. So basically, we allowed a customer to use our platform to move money, to move fund. Okay. You know, one example is Uber. You know, we're partnering with Uber, and which allowed their driver to get the money instant. Our audit team is have around 10 people right now, 10 to 12 people. The structure is we have a CAE, you know, and reporting to him as myself. I basically oversee the what I call the business audit department, focusing on compliance audit, operational audit, SOCs, for example. And we also have a IT team that is focusing, obviously, on cybersecurity, you know, and all the IT, GLBA, and all the other IT audit. In addition, we also have a data analytic team. With the two people, yes, exactly. So their real focus is data, to how to use data to support our audit program in general. Last but not least, we have our QA manager that is overseeing the QA program, and as well as a lot of support for the audit committee.
So of course, being a fintech company, I'm sure there's a lot of regulations in your areas. And you're always constantly trying to balance the internal audit projects that you do with maybe some of the things that you have to do based on the regulations. Maybe just talk a little bit about your internal audit plan and how you go about balancing those two things out.
Our audit plan is supported by our almost enterprise risk assessment. So we basically perform risk assessment at least once a year, at least, but probably more frequent when things change. And we want to address all the key risks of the company. Regulations, compliance is one of the biggest focus we have. You know, so as a bank holding company of Green Dot Corporation, you know, we need to comply with all the bank reg. You know, think about BSA AML, dispute reg E, privacy, all that stuff we need to comply with. So definitely very compliance focused. In addition, you know, SOX, as a public trade company of Green Dot, we need to comply with SOX as well. Not but not least, all the operational information security type of risk is also key to our audit program.
And how does that feed into not just the way that you interact with your risk assessment, but also with the audit committee and how you go about reporting to them?
We report things in a, number one, we report all our audits in a formal audit report. Just like any internal audit shop. Also on a quarterly basis, we have a quarter report to the audit committee to talk about any emerging risks we see. And in addition, our CAE have close relationship and I think dialogue communication with the head of audit committee. So if anything, we need their we need to work close to them. We need to they need to understand what are the risks of the company that we see, what direction we're going. We want to make sure we're lockstep, throughout the way. So,
what do you think are some of the challenges that your department faces, whether that be on a day-to-day basis or just some of the things that you, some of the challenges that you want to tackle over the next year or so?
The way I see it is, data and technology is key to the future success of the department and the industry, basically. I thought back of all the most significant audit finding I had in the past few years. All of them are discovered through data analytics.
Really?
It's not, it's not through the old-fashioned sample of 25, but data. And the result, just hold more weight into technology, the same thing. I mean, I cannot even quantify how many hours we spend on what I call those BC work and manual process. Just to preparing the quarterly deck for the AC is it's crazy. I mean, you download things from SharePoint, export it in the Excel, do all this chart and report it, where technology could help you automate a lot of those things. So I think those are really cool. But it's also kind of come to your question, what is the challenge? How do we integrate them without disturbing the current process? We still have an audit plan we need to fulfill every year. We still have all this work, tracking the management action plan, reporting to the audit committee, a lot of those things. How do we continue doing that while integrated and almost enhance what we do stuff. Yeah. Those are the real challenge for the next few years I see, yeah.
So you mentioned you have two data analytics focused people on your team.
Correct.
How do your internal auditors or your more traditional internal auditors integrate with the data analytics people?
Great question. So yes, they have hours allocated each audit to data analytics.
Yep.
And but obviously those hours, are based on estimate, and because we are one of the things that we really want to challenge our audit team, every auditor, is in every audit that we do, how do we better utilize data analytics in each audit? Just the fact that we didn't utilize it last year does not mean that there's no opportunity.
Right.
So to answer your second question, we try to involve the data team as part of planning. So as we finish our walkthrough, know what the scope of this audit, what is the key area we want to look at, we want to really sit down and brainstorm with the data team. Hey guys, these are the things, these are the objective we're trying to accomplish. What are the ways to do this? Let's just brainstorm in. Can we use data here? Does it make sense to do this? And what is the roadblock you have and things like that? So we have section like that to basically think, and if area we think we want to give it a shot, we do that. And oftentimes, it's not easy said than done. Oftentimes when we try to do something, ending up we find one way, reason or the other, we kind just come back and say, it's not doable. We need to go back to the old-fashioned way.
Switching gears maybe just a little bit, what are some of the new trends that you are embracing, maybe outside of data analytics? Mm-hmm. Or maybe what's a trend that you're a little pessimistic on that, maybe we're not quite there yet?
Robotic and AI. I think I'm just thinking about, using writing audit report, for example, right? I've been with the company for 8 years. The way our audit report structure is pretty much the same from 8 years ago.
Yeah.
So I sometimes keep on thinking, is that because it was perfect to begin with? I was reading the article the other day that is, this robotic thing that can almost write for you. You can give them data thing and write like narrative and like real writing for you, essay for you. So I think those are pretty cool. Those are the things I want to explore. Those are the things we want to see as a department whether we can utilize those technology to future enhance our program.
All right. Well, I want to thank you again for joining us on Audit Talks.
Thanks for having me.
It was a lot of fun just talking with you about what you're doing now and your ideas for the future. Hopefully you also enjoyed our time here for Audit Talks. Join us again for the next edition, and we'll see you next time.